everybody. Morning.
It's 9 o'clock in the morning. Welcome to FSFE's community meeting 2019 here at SFScon. That was last year in Strasbourg, our community meeting. Happy to be here in Bolzano this year. Thanks a lot to Patrick, our financial officer of the FSFE and the host here of SFScon for having us here. Very glad to be here in the mountains with the snow again. So thank you for that. I want to give you a quick overview of what FSFE did in the last 12 months, some highlights. We'll not be able to mention everything, but a few of the things, and also tell you a bit about what will happen today. And yes, then we will enjoy the rest of the day together. So I just quickly start with a topic where Carmen yesterday already gave a presentation, one of the keynotes here, about the reuse project. So one of our goals is to make it easy for people to use and develop free software. And the goal with the reuse project is to make license information easily readable by humans and machines, so the software can more easily be reused again, so that you don't have to care that much about, are those licenses in compliance, what do I have to care about. So that's the goal of this project. Carmen talked about it already yesterday. More information is available on the website. And we released a new version of the reuse project in August. So have a look at that. That's something we worked on in the last 12 months again. Also related to the reuse project, we used it in this activity, the next generation internet. So we are part of a consortium in the European, funding project. And the goal there is to build a platform, interoperable platform for openness, transparency, inclusiveness, and projects are applying there, and when they are accepted, the consortium of projects will help them to manage, to fulfill their obligations there, and we help them that their software is compliant, that all of the software is under free software license, you're using the reuse recommendations for that as well, and by the end of 2021, there will be 150 projects, all of them will be free software, and we will make sure to help them that they are license compliant. And Gabriel will talk about that at 3 o'clock today, so you will hear more. Furthermore, we were involved in an activity about the Radio Equipment Directive that's on a European level, and what they want to do is, or they are at the moment, the directive is hindering people to install free software on radio-capable devices. And that's nowadays almost everything, so from laptop to mobile phone to routers, everything which has some kind of Wi-Fi, 5G or other chips in there. And our goal there is to explain the regulators how problematic that is for free software. There's very little knowledge about that there at the moment. We have to try very hard to explain this. This regulation is already there, and we are working on this to help people to understand more how we can remove barriers to using free software in this area. Another regulation on the European level where we were involved in was the Copyright Directive. And so the Copyright Directive, as you might have seen, introduced some problematic filters. One thing we have been able to accomplish at least is that in the regulation, free software developing platforms are excluded. So that's, even so, the whole directive itself, there are a lot of problematic parts in there. We were able to make the regulators understand that free software is so important to have our own exception for this in there. And that's what we accomplished there together with many people who supported this activity. So one small room there and a recognition for free software within a regulation which lots of people agree is not the best regulation. So, Alex will later also talk about that in a policy talk. Then, we want to make sure that people understand more what free software is and how they can use it. And we were involved in an EU project called Phosphor SMEs, creating learning materials for small and medium-sized enterprises that they can better understand spend and use free software. And there's a project on from the Erasmus program. We were involved there in a consortium, created materials, and that's finished now a few weeks ago. The project was finalized, so there's now material there for smaller companies to learn more about free software so that they are also able to benefit from the advantages of free software there. And as you might have seen, our campaign Public Money, Public Code, we continue to work on this, raise awareness amongst politicians, about amongst civil servants, with people in our community about why it's important that publicly financed software should be published under free software license. Also, in the last 12 months, what is new is that we published an export brochure together with many people from the community, providing further information about this topic. And later at 12:40, Bonnie will have a talk about another smaller activity, which we now started for Public Money, Public Code, bringing this down to the local level, sending mails to mayors and educating them about free software. So, also related to public administrations, there was again some update from Munich. So long-term project there, and all the time also the source of a lot of misinformation about free software and why you can't use free software in the public administration. So our German team with Florian and Björn, they published an update about what is going on in Munich. Also that people outside of Germany learn about that. Usually there is a lot of information inside Germany, but not so much outside. So they published that, and then there was some good news there, because a political satirist, she received an award by the city of Munich. And in her award talk, she criticized the decision from the mayor to switch back to Microsoft Windows. So to make that a bit more clear, so the mayor in the middle here, he gave this award to the political satirist here on the left side, and she criticized the move and then took the 10,000 euros she got as an award and gave it to the organization of the guy back there with the video equipment who recorded the ceremony. So that's up here. So yes. That's what happened there, so we were very happy about that, receiving the donation and also the advertisement we received there, which was a huge town hall meeting, and then she was criticizing that. It was quite positive side there. We were also again involved in the European elections, so that's something we do for many years now, that for elections we contact politicians before, ask them about their positions on free software, and inform them about our positions. So we did that again for the European elections. We then also identified new allies in the parliament. So you have a lot of members of parliament moving out, lots of them moving in. You have to make sure that you have, again, good connections with people in the parliament. We did that, also organized again some policy events. And I'm very happy about that. We also had the Freedom Vote again in Switzerland. So Jami here will talk later about this, where we used the opportunity of the Swiss elections to educate people there about the positions of the candidates of free software and some other topics. But we will talk more about that later. One other topic where we were involved for a very long time, but which came now up again in the last 12 months again, was the topic of our freedom. So in Germany, we worked on that from 2013 to 2016, and we were able there to get a regulation that ISPs are not allowed to force you to use a certain router, which usually is using proprietary software. So you are able to choose your own router. We were able to accomplish that on a German level. It was even written in the coalition agreement that should be removed, and that was done. Now the whole thing comes up on the European level, so the same companies, they are trying to push now on the European level to override the German part as well. And what we did there was now translating a lot of materials we had in German about that topic and making sure that everybody out there in the European Union who wants to fight against this, that you can do so, that you have information there with arguments and background information which work in Germany. So we hope that we are able to prevent that from happening on the European level. We will monitor that. Lucas back there, he will also have a talk about that at 10:20. So keep an eye on that and let us know what is going on in your countries about that. Furthermore, we again had our I Love Free Software Day event. We criticize each other heavily during the whole year. We want to have one day where we say thank you to each other in the free software community. That's the 14th of February. And later at 2:10, we have a session where each one of you can give a short dedication to a free software program or a free software developer whom you appreciate and would like to say thank you and tell the others why you like that. So think about it and let us know when you want to say something. Register at the booth and then you can also have a small slot to tell us about your favorite free software program or developer and say thank you. Then the whole case about Huawei and the US government banning Huawei, that raised a lot of attention for our Free Your Android activities. So besides the talks and the workshops we give in this direction, there were a lot of companies who were interested in this topic, or who weren't interested in the topic before. So we helped a lot of people there to understand like what parts are free software, what parts aren't free software, what can you do to make sure that you can still use free software on your mobile phones. Later at Marvin over there will have a talk about Micro-G, which is a replacement for the Google Play services. So you can use free software in this area. So yeah, that's the activities there. Furthermore, we again organized our legal and licensing workshop. We have over 400 participants in the legal network discussing topics about free software, legal and licensing issues, helping them to connect with each other, to learn from each other, so that they are able to use more free software in their companies. We had a 12th workshop about that with 135 participants. And yeah, later Carlo will also give a talk. Later Carlo will give a talk about some basics around free software licensing. We also, it's important for the FSFE to have more volunteers contributing to the organization, so we also improve the information how you can do so. So our website fsfe.org/contribute was heavily improved, and hopefully this will have an effect on our next months of volunteer contributions. We also, for our infrastructure, it's important that our servers are running reliable, that our website is running reliable, improved as the first phase for a lot of people when they learn about the FSFE. So we again had several webathons from the web team, and our system team also had several in-person meetings to improve the infrastructure there. And later at 3:10, Florian from our system hackers team will give a presentation about some improvements they made for the blogging platform. When we have all those volunteers, we also want to make sure that other people see who is involved in the organization, who is supporting us, and why people are supporting us. So we also heavily improved or created a website now with highlighting the people who are involved, who are supporting us, who are contributing with their volunteer time. So on this website, we have a testimonials page also with some small videos where people explain what they are doing. And so later there's also a breakout session where if you want to contribute, you can also discuss some ways and what you can do. And so from 4:30 to 5:40, we have these sessions where you can group together and think about discussing something, working on something together. So that's the opportunity there. If you're interested in something, let us know at the booth and then we will register that, but I will also later explain that before the session. We had a lot of events again, so 60 events in over 11 countries, several talks about public money, public code. One other highlight was that we went more into the discussion about security in free software. Talked about sustainability, where Eric will later also give a presentation about. And yeah, lots of material, new material and merchandise. Our booth is over there. When you walk down there, you can always go there and make sure to equip yourself with the materials available. We have a new podcast. Listen to it on fsv.org/news/podcast. Let us know how you like it. And tomorrow we plan to have a walk together. So it's our plan to meet at the train station at 12:30 and walk a little bit up the mountains and around Bolzano. It should be around 2.5 to 3 hours. We have to see how the weather conditions are, so please let us know if you're interested in that and we will let you know on Sunday morning what exactly the plans are. And the other ones that it's more like this, not the other way around. So you already know when you have seen talks from me that I like this code a lot. So many small people in many small places do many small things that will alter the face of the world. Please don't lean back and think about these heroes coming and saving us and changing the world for us. That's not how we will make any change. It will be each one of you doing one small thing which you are able to change, and the sum of that, with this, we will be able to make a change. So thank you very much for being here and for helping others to make sure that they can use free software for any purpose without any discrimination, that people are able to understand how software works around us, that you are able and everybody is able to share software with others again, and that also we are able to improve software for our own needs, adopt it to our own needs, and not change ourselves as individuals, organization, or society to fit what someone else thought how we should work. So thank you very much, and I'm looking forward to the whole day with you. Thank you.